Alright, welcome to Space Engineers. Can I show my base here? Second here. Show you how things are set up a little bit. Here's how I always have mine set up with the mods, and then only one I really highly recommend would be the long range ore detectors. And then sneaky sounds if you're doing videos, of course. That way it makes the grinder and the drill not so loud. The paint gun, that one's pretty cool. Under here, just crank all these up. Normally, if I'm going on to like a moon or something like that, I turn this off. But on planets, I keep it on normally. The in-game scripts, turn that on in case I import a vehicle that has scripts. Enable progression, I turn that off because I've already done all that. Let's get started. I like this, how it has the different, you know, knowledge points and all that stuff. Okay, so here we are. I always like to be by ice lakes. Okay, turn all these off for stage here. Okay, got my rover here. It's 14 blocks long. Got the cockpit, the batteries on two on each side, or one on each side. Gyros on each side, and then ore detector. On the top is the antenna. And conveyor tube, and then O2 HQ generator. And the medium container, full of ice. Then the hydrogen engine, which is indirectly connected to the O2 HQ generator, using the small port on the medium container. And a container in the back so that I can separate the ice from the ores that I'll be collecting. On this one, I'm going to be building a hydrogen-powered ship that can take us to space. First thing I need to do is get some ice. Now, this ship I basically built it using a tutorial made by Splitzy. And this one can hold about 400k of ice. Let's get started. Gotta make sure this thing stays level for the most part. Okay, how much ice do I have? I'll get a little bit more and then go to the base after this. Just a second here. I think what I like about this one is you can mine a whole bunch of ore and then it still flies. Let's see what we got now. Yeah, that should work out. Pull the base out of there. If it were ores, then it would be going directly to the refinery right now. But the refinery can't do anything with ice. Okay. I'd like to build the gyros first. Go right here and get the small grid pieces here. Gyro right there. And it automatically builds the required materials. It's one thing I like about the advanced assembler. Next, we're going to build the ore detector and the antenna. And with the ore detector mod, I can build the 8x1. And you can position the antenna however you'd like. Okay, I'm gonna build two hydrogen tanks. This is gonna be a double engine one. Or should I say double main engine. Thank you. Okay, so almost done here. Oh yeah, these pipes are pretty heavy. Let's get things started here. Okay, put it as far back as possible. Let's just put the materials in here. Just tap the welder. Okay, let's get the rest of the materials. Now we need a O2 H2 generator, two of them. Now at the mine I'm building a double, hydrogen tank system anyway, but you can do a single system also. Okay, so now for the cockpit placement, but I'm going to build the conveyors first. These conveyors and also this conveyor here, they both use the same amount of materials. So I'm just going to hit this 8 times. There we go, just like that so far. Kind of a big S right there. Okay, now for the cockpit. There we go. I'm going to build some medium containers. Okay, here's how I'm going to set these up. Okay, going to need a connector. I'll come back if there'll be materials for the thrusters. Two large ones. I'm not doing that yet. Okay, now the thrusters. Okay, let's put some ice in this thing. 10k at a time. If I were to manually drill the ice, then I'd be making a whole bunch of trips. So for now, let's just put that in there. So I do 11 of the conveyors. These ones here, the small conveyors, the splitter ones. Then I'll need 27 of the small thrusters. Building, let's put these on here. Okay, so we have that. Now we're just waiting on this here. And it's just about done. There we go. Since these are heavy, then I'm going to take these first. There we go. Hydrogen thrusters, they need to be hooked up to the conveyor system to transfer the gases to the thrusters. Ah, here we go. Actually, I'd like to put a couple of thrusters on each of these O2H2 generators also. That way we have plenty of stopping power. Okay, we need the hydrogen engine. Start, I'll build the conveyor junction. Just one of these. looks like I need 4 conveyors for each side. Plugging into this port right here. Okay, these are all lined. I've had one build before where I actually had these mislined, and then I was wondering why this thing wasn't running or getting any hydrogen or producing any. And I looked and it's like, wait. Okay, I'm gonna recharge my suit energy. I have the large O2H generator connected to the survival kit. And I need to fill up my hydrogen. I have plenty of ice in here. There we go. Almost done. Just need the 2 batteries. As you can see, there's one green dot, which is basically the 25% mark. Hydrogen tanks are already being filled up. This takes quite a while. Let's see here. Turn this on. Hydrogen engine on, sometimes it'll stop the production of the hydrogen fuel for, you know, the hydrogen in the tanks and all that stuff. Now what I do for the time being, I just turn the engine off and just let this fill up. One more thing, I'm just going to put a landing gear onto here in a different position. Okay, it's basically complete for now, but all I'm going to do is I'm going to be putting ice into here, or more ice, and then basically after that I'll get it all set up and then we'll take off into space. So let's see. We'll be right back. Okay, we're back. Oh, my chip's gone. Just kidding. I put it over here. I made a connector right there and then connected the chip. Okay, and it's fully charged up and ready to go. Okay, let's see what's going on here. Ah, there we go. Okay, let's get it set up for a flight. For the K menu. I'll select all the hydrogen thrusters here. Even the large ones. Don't want to forget those. And let's group them. Now let's select all the backward thrusters. We'll group those. Group the batteries also. Let's group these O2 H2 generators. There we go. Crank up the range on this ore detector. And one thing I keep forgetting to build, the spotlights. Two of those. I'll just put it right there. Put these away here. Disassemble those. Okay, so it looks like we're mostly ready to take off. P to disengage. There we go. Okay, let's get out of here. didn't set up a ship. Oh, that's right. Toolbar on the right, there's a circle with a plus in there. Basically, that's showing what direction you're going for the most part. Wherever the plus is, that's where basically forward is. First asteroid there. On the bottom right, I still have 83% of my hydrogen. On the bottom, close to the circle, there's the P gravity, which is planetary gravity, at 0.24 g. Counting down. Start getting stuff set up in the G menu like I should have earlier. because we're at 0.09 G's right now, 0.08 now. Since I have the forward thrusters off, or you know, the backward thrusters off, and also the dampers are back on, turn this way. Just go that way for me. There we go. And with the dampers off, then this happens. Now I'm still going towards that asteroid. Now on, it corrects my direction and all that stuff. Okay, let's start slowing down. Well, no horse to speak of so far on this one. That's probably because I have my... this turned off. There we go. Hit H. Just ice. Somehow the asteroid is in gravity but not falling. Kind of interesting. Okay, now we're in space and there's no gravity. See what this asteroid has. Well, this is what happens if you get out. Do a little spacewalk. You have your dampers on, they're all the ones that will keep you with your vehicle. But if you turn them off and back on again, your vehicle's gonna fly away. Oh, there's the moon. If you were to try to fly to that Mars planet, it takes about 5 hours. Real time, I should say. Unless, of course, you build a large scale ship and then put a jump drive in there, then this takes a few minutes. Okay, we're approaching this asteroid. looks like I'm only finding ice so far, but yeah, you'll find all the different ores out here in the asteroids. Well, as always, if you like the video, go ahead and hit like and subscribe and all that stuff. Let's see here. Well, that's all for now. See you later.